President Trump released his budget request, and unfortunately, the policies it proposes would be disastrous for the country. Even a cursory glance shows his budget would present enormous hardship for households that already struggle to make ends meet. Trump's budget calls for cutting SNAP, formerly known as food stamps, by $220 billion over 10 years, which is roughly 30% of the program. This would throw millions of people off the program and cut benefits for many more. This policy is unbelievably cruel. No one in the richest country on earth should go hungry, no matter what. But in addition to being cruel, it's also bad policy. Children with access to SNAP are more likely to complete high school and are less likely to have heart disease. In 2015, SNAP kept about 3.8 million children out of poverty. It also lifts adults and the elderly out of poverty as well, 8 million people in total. After giving nearly $2 trillion in tax cuts over 10 years, Congress doesn't need to be pinching pennies when it comes to food for hungry people. With benefits already small at only $1.40 per person per meal on average, we should be expanding the program rather than cutting it.
The Trump budget would also be a disaster for healthcare in this country. His budget repeals the Affordable Care Act, which helped 20 million Americans gain coverage. It would eliminate the ACA's Medicaid expansion, which now covers 13 million Americans. And it doesn't stop there. The Trump budget would make additional massive cuts to the rest of Medicaid program, which could harm low-income senior citizens, individuals with disabilities, children, pregnant women and mothers, and Americans working at poverty wages. In all, it would cut Medicaid roughly $1.5 trillion over 10 years, leaving millions more Americans without health insurance. And while it would sink some of that money back into a block grant program, that new program would subject people to work requirements and co-pays. It would fundamentally destroy the guarantee of health insurance for low-income people and threaten protections for individuals with pre-existing conditions.
The budget also shortchanges future generations by cutting programs critical for the long-term success of the country. In the first year alone, the budget calls for a 12% cut to the National Institutes of Health, which funds most of the nation's search for cures to cancer, heart disease, and AIDS, a 14% cut to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, which works to prevent epidemics, a 13% cut to the National Science Foundation, a 31% cut to the Environmental Protection Agency, and all of these cuts get deeper over time. In fact, these and other programs, such as education, transportation, housing, national parks, veterans' health, and law enforcement, are taken as a whole cut by $1.3 trillion over the decade.
Here's just a small list of programs that the Trump budget would completely eliminate. Community Service Block Grant, which gives states and localities funding to help local nonprofits alleviate poverty and address its root causes. The Low-Income Home Energy Assistance Program, which helps poor households pay their energy bills to keep their houses warm in the winter and cool in the summer. The Public Service Loan Forgiveness Program, which forgives people student loans after 10 years of working for a nonprofit organization or in public service. In fact, in total, the budget calls for $207 billion in cuts to loan and grant programs. The Preschool Development Grants Program, which gives money to states to build or strengthen preschool programs. The Public Housing Capital Fund, which repairs dilapidated public housing buildings. The Community Development Fund, which sends money to cities and towns to promote housing, infrastructure, and other programs that contribute to growth. All of these budget cuts help finance the thing that Trump cares about most, more tax cuts for the richest among us. Trump's budget calls for making permanent his tax cuts, which overwhelmingly help the rich, giving 71% of the benefit to the top 20%. Over just 4 years, this will cost $1.1 trillion.
Fortunately, most of these proposals are unlikely to be enacted. But this is what the United States would look like if President Trump and congressional Republicans get their way. Fundamentally, budgets are statements of priorities, and this budget makes crystal clear that Republicans prioritize cutting programs that lift people out of poverty.